we read every edition of records that classified and...
Every edition? All please with you? Good lord. I know no one isn't the most exciting place, but...
All 332 and the specials, and I went through and corrected every typo.
And come on, Red Alert. I know spare quotes when I hear them, and yours are always deafening.
And they weren't typos. Iron Fist didn't make mistakes. He left clues. If you remove the first 80 wrong letters and rearrange them, you get a message. These aren't mistakes.
So, cracking the code reveals the existence of the code?
Layers, marks, clues within clues, false starts, fake false starts, layers. So don't be surprised when I tell you that the next batch of letters, more or less spells, don't trust these messages. Why have you gone quiet?
Sorry, Red. Distracted. I'm picking up images of a crashed ship. And it looks cyber-familiar.
It doesn't belong to Demus.
You tell me. I'm linking you the feed.
Okay, go a match. It's an exploration vessel. Model 84. The Pre-Atropy Principle. Autobot registered, but linked to a crew of Decepticons, deserters known as the Scavengers.
Fine, I'll deal with them after Demus.
Deal with them?
It's our job to arrest anyone with South Cybertronian technology to less advanced races. They call themselves Scavengers. Join the dots.
Nothing here suggests they ever acted in breach of the Tyrus Accord. There is reports that they supplied Brainstorm with spare parts, but that's all. Certainly nothing that Ultra Magnus would consider.
My predecessor was too rigid. He'd only take an interest in criminals after the crime. Sometimes a little preemptive action is called for, especially when Decepticons are involved. So come on then, these scavengers. Who am I up against?
Okay, so courtesy of Autopedia. Fire of Britannia is a debonair sharpshooter who once fired a bullet through a bullet-shaped hole in a slightly larger bullet while riding a bullet train, feared and respected by his colleagues. He is credited for introducing Megatron to the world of interpretive dance.
Pretendia, I think that's an iron.
Rocket of Solex is a hard-headed fighter pilot famous for coining the phrase, hold your horses. He once single-handedly shot down a fleet of Autobot starfighters. He couldn't use both hands, but he wanted to keep one in reserve. Vice Admiral Spencer was created as a practical joke by a team of scientists in response to a shortage of...
Gonna have to stop you there, Red. We've arrived. I'm putting you on visor. This shouldn't take long.
Really? For something that shouldn't take long, you're carrying an awful lot of firepower.
The two are connected.
One summary execution later.
You didn't have to kill him!
He had a gun.
But you didn't have to kill him!
He had a gun!
I give up.
Demus was filth even by your standards. Don't pretend you don't know what he did.
They easy on the double negatives! Some of us struggle!
Shut up. You're all under arrest.
Ha! Bad luck, guys.
All of you.
All of us? Why?
Trafficking Cybertronian technology.
Oh, get over it. Hate to do you out of a job, but our high tech ain't that high tech anymore. It's just tech. About 4 million years ago, we stopped reaching for the stars because we needed both hands to beat the crap out of each other. We're not even number one when it comes to weapons of mass destruction.
True! Did you know that the Galactic Council have built a geobomb, bright, red, size of an eyeball, that can vaporize planets? Size of an eyeball planets. It makes me embarrassed for Killmaster's moon gun.
The geobomb is based on Killmaster's designs.
That's... really? You're not just saying that to prove a point.
So, what happens next? I mean, you killed 10,000 of us at Simansi, so we're not about to fight you.
Escort you to my ship, take you back to base, and lock you up.
What? How? Like, right now? That's a shame. I was kind of hoping for an opportunity to escape.
It's not going to happen.
What if I distract you long enough for my colleague to turn his rotor blades into a bludgeon and hit you over the head?
What?
Gotta love the choom choom.
If you ever say that again, I'll turn Nick's guns on you.
Split up! He can't chase us all!
Which way is out?
I don't know. I wasn't paying attention.
You never pay attention.
I pay attention all the time. You just never notice.
Decepticons, I'm coming for you.
I think we lost him. Enough for the bloody clicking.
Maybe
if you say anything about calling in your old squad, I swear I'm gonna full thunderwing on you.
But I'm trying.
You're not. You're really not. Because they're dead, Croc. They're all dead. Give it. Here. Guys, keep it down.
Your friend Demas, he wasn't a very nice person. You know that, right? Come out and I'll tell you all about it.
There. See? See, it's not a communicator. It's some poor sod's index finger. And I'm sick of pretending otherwise.
It's a finger and a communicator. And more besides. Poor Raider turned it to a portable telecom system. He was a wonderful fellow. Bright and warm and decent. Just a decent person. Like everyone else in my squad, he was murdered by the Wreckers. Robuster had some kind of psych spasm he was obviously using. He tore out Raider's spine and made him eat it. It was a horrible affair. I took what was left of him. And this part of him. This part can detect spark signatures bearing a Decepticon marker. I click when I'm anxious, but I also click when we're in trouble, and I need to know if there are any Decepticons nearby. Usually, there aren't. Today, as usual, there... Today there are! Today there are hundreds!
Demas was a slave trader. Look around. Look at the merchandise. The robots aren't made from scrap. They're made from us, from Autobots and Decepticons that Demas modified and turned into product.
Demas wasn't selling Cybertronian tech. He was selling Cybertronians.
He called it domestication. And it's irreversible. Find a vulnerable Cybertronian, someone with a beast mode, and mutilate them. Carefully, methodically, internally. Detect their T-Core to stop them changing. remove the vox pods to stop them screaming, and then you rewire their brains, hack away till all that's left is a vague smudge of self-awareness. And then you're good to go, box them up and ship them out. Advertise them as torture dolls, half dead, but alive enough to feel whatever stunt.
We didn't know any of that! Right?
Swear to God.
You know what he said? You know what he said when I challenged him? When I told him I was gonna hunt him down? It's a survivor's market. That was his defense. The war's over, he said. A lot of organics are prepared to pay a lot of money to take their frustrations out on a Cybertronian who won't fight back.
Miss Fire, I'm worried Fortress Maximus will find out about Grimlock. What should we do?
Mods are intercepting our transmission. You're not going to leave the earth with Grimlock.
Impossible.
It checks out. I found his prisoner stamp, G9 coding. It is marked 107 miles U.S. It is his monster ship.
In that case, change of priorities.
Engines, getting quieter. I think he's leaving. How about that?
Hey, Croc, what you said just now about radar, about your squad, you should have told me earlier.
For a while, I couldn't talk about it at all. In fact, for a while, I convinced myself that the rest of my squad were still out there, that they were safe.
Yeah, Crankcase used to say you were nuts.
See? And people wonder why it's so hard to talk about mental health.
Hey, I'm a paragon of sensitivity.
It's not just the labeling, it's the distancing. It's this idea that experiencing mental illness marks you as a bad different. Show me someone who hasn't been affected by all the fighting. Show me someone who's normal, and I will show you someone who knows how to hide things. We are our brains, subject this ball of circuitry to 4 million years of war and hate and pain and death and loss and grief. And don't be surprised if it has to find new ways to cope with the stress. People should be more understanding. That's what I was going to do with my $500 million. Build a treatment center for vulnerable Decepticons. Because there are a lot of people out there who are only just about holding it together.
You hypocrite.
I'm sorry?
You absolute hypocrite. People should be more understanding. Grimlock needs our help more than anyone, yet you were prepared to sell him down the river.
Only so I could help others. That was a means to an end.
Our furious Autobot Prime has officially left the building.
Crankcase, what was all that about before? That message?
Oh, that was intended for Force Max. I knew he'd head up for the WAP once he knew Grimlock was inside. Save a fellow Autobot or kill some mouthy Decepticons. It's a no-brainer!
You utter pinhead! Grimlock was a prisoner on Garrus 9. Max isn't gonna rescue him. He's gonna re-arrest him. And Grimlock will resist and they'll fight and we've gotta help him!
I agree.
You what now? You were gonna sell him 10 minutes ago?
I was wrong. And Fulcrum was right. Grimlock is one of us. He deserves our protection.
How are we gonna protect him against Maximus? We can't even protect ourselves!
Relax. I have a strategy.
Right then. Maximus has a head start, but if you two get us all airborne, we can get to the WAP before him and Skeletal.
Except, we can't fly until the inhibitor chips have worn off. We're walking.
Not necessarily.
The Weak Entropic Principle.
Grimlock, this is your warden speaking. It's time you went back in your cell. Of course, it won't be on Garrus 9. Thanks to Overlord, Garrus 9 doesn't exist anymore. for me. You don't know how that all panned out. After Overlord attacked, and before the Wreckers took an interest, you left. You ran away, and I'd really like to talk to you about that. There you are. I knew you'd be excitable, so if this is supposed to amaze me, it doesn't.
Keep him away from your face, Mark. I nearly lost you. You forget.
Never. Better. You're a con now? Or should I say you're a con again?
That's it, Jimmy Hart. He's a party day. If you have to, but don't keep him.
He wouldn't extend the same courtesy to me. He's a Decepticon. And all they care about is themselves.
I don't feel comfortable doing this.
That's because you're doing it wrong. You've got to straddle them like this.
That's not what I meant.
Over there, gunshots.
Okay, here goes nothing.
What the?
Let's talk!
Why? Because you think you've evened the odds? I walked away from Simansi smiling. I think I can handle 6 cons and a herd of equinoids.
I don't know what you think is going on here, but Grimlock isn't our prisoner. Neither is he our ally. We found him, and not on Garrus 9.
What are you talking about?
He's not well. We've been trying to help him get better.
Is this true, Red?
You know my motto. Assume you're being lied to.
Grimlock? How do I know you're not to blame for his condition? Torturing prisoners until they turn inwards is a very Decepticon thing to do.
Jeez, generalize much. Typical Autobot.
I suggest you bring him back here and get him checked up by a professional. Let Cerebros take a look at him.
He's coming with me. I'll make sure he gets the help he needs. I promise.
What?
If you give a damn, not that I think you do, you'll want what's best for him.
Okay.
Hold your horses! Doesn't Grimlock get to say something about this? Just because he doesn't talk much doesn't mean he doesn't understand what's going on.
I take it back. That's a dreadful negative.
What do you want to do, Grimlock? Stick with us or go with him?
Don't expect an epic monologue.
Here we go, me Grimlock!
Okay, that's beyond settled. He's staying.
It's irrelevant. You're all coming with me, remember?
Think again. Grimlock!
We planted a bomb.
A what?
A bomb in Demas' office. Lots of innocent robots nearby.
You're lying.
And I suppose I just happened to be holding this detonator. They're prime. 30 minutes and counting. If you hurry, you might get there in time to deactivate it.
Where did you even find the bomb?
Fulcrum's an explosive expert. He can make a bomb out of anything.
Oh, really? What have you got to say about that, Red?
It actually takes off. According to Albia, Fulcrum of Kinex has focused on ordnance ever since he won a medal for object bravery.
Give that to!
Oh, no you don't! Yours, Grand Case!
One more step and I'll detonate it now! One more click and I'll bang, right, cock?
Half the robots are Decepticons. You'd be blowing your own.
So? It's each gun for themselves, surely you know that by now!
I know that you're bluffing. I won't forget this. I will find you. I will.
Put us down, yeah. Whatevs, TTFN. That was a hell of a face-off, Crackcase. Hell of a face-off. Nerves of steel, Crackcase.
Crackcase?
Official paralysis again.
That was brilliant, everyone. That was teamwork. And Misfire, I take it all back. Vandalizing Autopedia is a productive use of our time. Shinix, love it!
Our repairs at 100%. We are ready to fly. Where next?
Everywhere. You're looking at every Decepticon in the vicinity. 100 lost souls.
I don't get it.
I finally do. I spent years comparing myself with Decepticons. Who've done well for themselves. People like Agonizer and Skullcruncher. Today I realize that, you know what? I've done well. For a while, I was a mess, and my squad had died. I was directionless. I was delusional. I got better thanks to you guys. Even when I've made bad decisions, you've given me stability and support and companionship. And maybe it's time we give those things to other Decepticons.
What you're describing sounds suspiciously like helping people.
I know, because guess what? I think we'd be pretty good at it.
It's a nice plan, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's a little unfinished business to attend to. Fast reflexes for a strategist. Of course, you can hold two guns now. Didn't take that into account, now did I? Your quarters are a mess. We'll get this fixed, don't worry. No locks on the door this time. Not on the outside anyway.
Thanks, I appreciate that.
What did you just say? You said something. Just then, a proper sentence. Say it again. No, Grimsy. Sometimes you remind me of Spinster. Every now and then, say something, or do something. It makes me think there's a lot more going on in there than we realize. More than you realize, too. Guess all I can do is be patient. Pay attention. See what you do next.
Later.
I don't know, Ron. They weren't like any Decepticons I've encountered before.
How many Decepticons have you encountered seeing the war ended?
Why?
Well, I venture that these days, the scavengers are the rule, not the exception.
If that's true, I may have to rethink my approach.
I think that might be wise. And the bomb in the slave trader's office?
There was no bomb. I was duped. I thought I'd be angry, but in the end, I couldn't help smiling. One of them even left me a note.
You were hung! I've had a quick look and I reckon the domestication process is reversible. You can turn their brains back to normal. Instructions overleaf.
And the robots?
All taken care of.